Hi, AT from CNC at Home. If you remember when we set up the rotary roller, we noticed that the movement back and forth seemed to be off somehow. I'd move 10 or 20 millimeters one direction, and then I'd move back and it wouldn't be in the same spot. After working with SainSmart on this issue, they determined that there was a problem with the what I was burning actually moving. And so what I'm going to do is a little bit of an experiment to see if it actually is the rotary tool itself being off or if my material is sliding somehow. So I'm just doing a little bit of back and forth here to see if the movement changes. So I'm at just past 80 here and I'm going up to 100. Don't care where I stop, but when I come back, am I just past 80 or am I further away from it? Hard to tell. Let's do it again. Let's move away from it and then come back. It looks like I'm getting further and further away. Okay, so there's definitely an error coming into play here. Now, is it my straight edge moving or is the rotary roller not getting me back to where I started? We're definitely off by an amount. See that change? So we're off by about a good millimeter and a half to 2 millimeters. So let's do this. Look at where that mark is. What I'm going to do is move, and then I'll come back and see if that mark's in the same spot. I'm moving at 500 millimeters per minute, so nice and slow on this. And let's go back now and see if we end up in the same spot where we started. Well, that looks pretty close. It looks like exactly where we were when we started. So let's try it again. And this time I'm going to move at 1,000 millimeters per minute. Okay, that's right where we started. There have been a few back and forths, and we're ending up right exactly where we started. So it looks like the rotary roller is working correctly. Let's put the laser dot right on that and do the same experiment. Yeah, right back where we started. Oops, don't kick the tripod. Okay, so the laser dot's right on my mark. Let's move faster. So even at high speeds, it's getting right back to where it started. So it does look like my material is what's slipping, not the rotary roller itself. Right where we started. Let's go back and see if we end up in the same spot. Right on the money. Okay, so it looks like the rotary roller is being very accurate, and it's just when we have material on there, since it's not clamped down to the rollers, which you really can't do, it's slipping back and forth. So the important note here is to move slower and maybe have something that's a little bit heavier.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.